Sweet Tea with Coach Key.
Let's just get down to it.
Welcome to Sweet Tea with Coach Key. Coach Key.
Sweet Tea with Coach Key.
Real life stories of inspiration, perseverance, and prosperity.
Turn your radio up as loud as possible.
Sweet Tea with Coach Key.
I hope you have your teacups ready, because she has the sugar.
Nothing like a cup of brown sugar to sweeten my day.
Now let's enjoy some Sweet Tea with Coach Key.
Sweet Tea with Coach Key. Welcome to this week's episode, and I am so super excited to to share where I am this week and what's in my mind and what's in my spirit that I want to just share with you all. And I always say this, but I think it's also very cliche, that life is a journey. And I've always been the type of person who likes to sort of watch, I guess, kind of watch the market as it relates to the miracles of God, how you can pray about something. Well, first go through it, pray through it, and then make it through it. And even like this morning, let's just say this morning, right? So I didn't sleep very well last night. For some odd reason, I just could not. Like, I was asleep, but I wasn't resting. And I think that's a big difference. If I'm twisting and turning and all of this, I'm not really resting. Like, I need a really good restful sleep. And last night, I didn't get that. So I woke up, I prayed, I surfed the internet, I was looking up crazy stuff like how to exercise your face, like how to make your face slimmer. I'm looking up crazy stuff online because I just could not sleep. And finally, I was like, Lord, I just want to go back to sleep. Please, Jesus, please. So finally, around 3 o'clock, I fell into this deep, peaceful, incredible slumber, whatever it's called. And it was just so amazing. But before I knew it, boom, 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 the alarm clock was going off and it was time to get up. But anyway, when I got up this morning, even though I didn't get a lot of sleep, I knew when I woke up this morning, one of the first things that I was going to do was go to the gym. And I did it. Despite me not getting an immense amount of sleep, great sleep, despite how I may have even felt, I still made sure that I kept my word to myself and went to the gym. And not only did I go, I was a little late getting there. And if you followed me for a while, you know that that was something I used to struggle with. Even when I was like 100 pounds lighter, I would always beat myself up for not being on time, making it to the gym. Not the fact that I got there and worked my butt off and did more than what I thought I was going to do. None of that mattered. At the time, my mindset was just stuck on the fact that I was late. So I don't really, you know, give that much thought anymore, but I was delayed getting there. And when I got there, I completed my whole 45 minutes. I got tired. I didn't get discouraged though. That was the biggest thing. I wasn't trying to talk myself out of being good to myself. And what made me think about that for this particular episode was the progress. I think for so long I've been lifting myself in prayer for this mindset as it relates to pull and tug with temptation and strongholds, and just seeing those chains fall, and also seeing in some cases them try to present themselves again. But the miracle in the journey is incredible to me. So I just encourage you to reflect a little bit, not what you're currently experiencing, not what you're currently going through. None of that. Go back 5-10 years back. And even if you find yourself in a place where you're like, dang, I was doing better back then than I am now, keep in mind that you could have given up. So even if, at one point I was 400 pounds and I got down to 100 and something pounds. And now I am I'm in the middle. And I could just focus on the fact that I've gained weight again. Or I can focus on the fact that I have lost it before, and I am not going to give up on losing it again. No matter how many times I may slip up or make a mistake, I'm not going to give up. And the fact that I have not given up to this point. So the journey, I don't know how you feel about seeing people that you went to school with, maybe even their parents, there's someone in their family losing their life or not waking up the next morning. I don't know how that makes you feel if you've had that experience, but I know that I have, and I know that there's a blessing in still being in this journey, in this race. And sometimes I have to do a perspective shift, and it's quite often, because perspective is free. It's free. So when it's free, you can take what you want, right? And oftentimes with free, we like convenient. And with that, convenient is most of the time complaining. But I encourage you to set yourself in a position where your thoughts are prosperous and they're fruitful to your life, and you concentrate on your thoughts and your mindset and your perspective being aligned with God's word for your life. The Bible says if God is within you, you cannot fail, no matter what that looks like. Repossession, breakups, miscarriages, abortions, bankruptcy, late payments, whatever, you cannot fail. Whatever that thing is not a end all be all of your life, of your name, of your destiny, of failure. Continue on your journey one step at a time, one day at a time, one decision at a time, and enjoy the rest of your week. Take care.